Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to another video. It's Grace, and using your astute powers of observation, you might have immediately noticed that this is a different background than usual. And that is because I am currently visiting my parents, and from here, I have a very exciting day planned. I am going to be going book shopping in downtown Toronto with my lovely friend, Julia. And I want to take you along with me. So this is going to be my first ever attempt at a vlog. So wish me luck, but I am super excited for this because my friend Julia, she is kind of my resident Toronto expert because 90% of what I know about Toronto is how to get to like the Christmas market, a Leafs game, a Jays game, or the mall. So Julia actually went to university in the downtown area, and so she is going to be taking us to some bookshops, and we're gonna go around and I think see some really nice little parts of the city, and I'm really looking forward to it. So, like I said, I have not filmed something like this before, but we are gonna do our best, and I will check in with you at some time soon. So, see you in a bit. Now that I have teleported to the train, it's been quite a long time since I've been on the GO train to Toronto because I haven't had occasion since COVID to actually go downtown. I am in a section of the train by myself, which is why I'm talking. But honestly, I don't remember whether I said this in my first clip. I just wanted to say I'm so excited to see my friend Julia. It has been a really long time since, well, we've seen each other a couple of times, but we always used to do fun things like this, like going to Toronto together, whether it was to see a Jays game or a Leafs game or whatever. And I'm really excited to be getting back to doing this with her. So that's just awesome. And since I have about an hour on the train, I decided, because I am so smart, that I am going to start Under the Whispering Door by TJ Klune, because I do have that on the NetGalley app on my phone. So, which I can't show you because I am currently filming on my phone. But, you know, it's gonna be a good time. I will see you later. Okay, hello. This is me catching up at the end of the day. I'm a little bit frazzled and looking a little damp. You might be able to tell because it is absolutely pouring rain, and you can probably hear it. And because of who I am as a person, I usually park pretty far away in parking lots just because I don't mind walking. But I do mind walking when I have a bunch of books in a bag and it's pouring. Anyway, I survived, I saved the books, and I'm just gonna do like a mini haul right here, right now, to show you what I got today. Did I buy entirely too much? Yes, but I actually am quite proud of the diversity of what I bought. So to be fair, I think that it was a very successful shopping trip day of hanging out with my friend, book shopping. So I'm just gonna pull these out of the bag, and whatever order they're coming in, they're coming. First up, we have For the Wolf by Hannah Witten. And I've had my eye on this one for a while. And basically I just saw it and it called to me today. And this is, like, by all accounts, this looks like it should be a Little Red Riding Hood retelling, but I'm almost positive that it is, like, sort of Little Red Riding Hood, sort of Beauty and the Beast. Because basically what this says is the first daughter is for the throne and the second daughter is for the wolf. And I think the whole concept here is that the second daughter of the royal family, I'm assuming since the first daughter is for the throne, gets sacrificed to the wolf of the wood. So I think it's like the wolf isn't actually a beast, it's a man, and we'll see where it goes from there. I do think that the book looks really intriguing. I absolutely love the cover, so excited about that one. The second book that I got today, let's take a look in our mystery box, is In Cold Blood by Truman Capote. This looks very intriguing. So it says, on November 15th, 1959, in the small town of Holcomb, Kansas, four members of the Clutter family were savagely murdered, and Truman Capote is reconstructing the murder and the investigation that led to the capture, trial, and execution of the killers. So this, like, I've heard of this book. I think it's very famous, but I had never actually really known what it was or much about it. So when I saw it, I just, like, it looked good and I thought that I would pick it up. Third up, we have 21 Things You May Not Know About the Indian Act. So this is about the Indian Act from 1876 in Canada, which has governed Indigenous people's lives in this country for, like, almost 150 years. So this is very, like, necessary reading, in my opinion. I've seen this book around. I have wanted to read it. It's just one of those ones where I guess I've never, like, gone online and bought it. When I saw it in the store, though, I knew that I needed it. And this is very small, so hopefully it, well, I'm sure it won't be an easy read, not in that sense, but just based on the fact that this is relatively short, I'm hoping that this is going to be something that I can fit in soon and read it, because, like, I want to know what's in here, because I think it's going to be very important. The fourth book that I picked up was Johnny Appleseed by Joshua Whitehead, and I am going to read the back of this one because I don't want to get this wrong. What it says is, "You're going to need a rock and a whole lot of medicine," is a mantra that Johnny Appleseed, a young two-spirit, Indigiqueer, and NDN glitter princess, repeats to himself in this vivid and utterly compelling debut novel by Joshua Whitehead. Off the res and trying to find ways to live, love, and survive in the big city, Johnny has 1 week before he must return to his home and his former life to attend the funeral of his stepfather. The 7 days that follow are like a fevered dream. Stories of love, trauma, sex, kinship, ambition, and heartbreaking recollections of his beloved Kokum grandmother. Johnny's life is a series of breakages, appendages, and linkages, and as he goes through the motions of preparing to return home, he learns how to put together the pieces of his life. Johnny Appleseed is a unique, shattering vision of Indigenous life full of grit, glitter, and dreams. So, this is, like, this sounds fantastic. It is very critically acclaimed. You can see that it has those three stickers on there to show some awards that it has won, or I guess it's been a finalist for a few. Honestly, this, in the same vein as the 21 Things You Need to Know About the Indian Act, I think that it's going to be an important read for the same sort of reasons, even though they're going to be different. This is a novel and the other one is nonfiction. There are obviously some big differences here, but I just want to get, like, more into that realm of Indigenous literature. So this looked very good as well. I got this from a little independent bookshop, so that's awesome. And yeah, this just looks great. Okay, the fifth book that I got is Men at Arms by Terry Pratchett, which is obviously switching gears a little bit from the last two, but I saw this in Indigo and I wanted to pick it up because I want to continue the City Watch subseries of Discworld at some point soon because I absolutely loved Guards. And so like I could not be more excited to continue with this. So next up is another nonfiction, and that is HIV Prevention and Bisexual Realities. And this is another one that I'm going to read the back of because I think it's really important that I accurately portray the content in here. Because when I picked this up and read the back of it, it is what made me want to pick it up and buy it. So here we go. Since HIV is a virus that can be transmitted through unprotected sexual relations, what kinds of educational materials are available to people who have sexual partners of both sexes? As soon as one asks this question, one is confronted with a dilemma. Indeed, although HIV is transmitted through sexual relations, it is extraordinarily difficult to find information that is directed explicitly to people who have sexual relations with both men and women. This absence raises additional questions. How is it that people who are involved with both men and women have been overlooked? What can this gap tell us about our collective response to HIV and AIDS? How do decisions about HIV education get made? The message to send, the populations to reach, the places to distribute materials. Who is involved in the work of education? How do specific campaigns get funded? This project takes up the challenge of answering these questions. So that is from the introduction of this book. This strikes me as almost like an academic paper. It has multiple authors. It's published by the University of Toronto Press. So I think that this is very academic, which draws me to it. And I just think that this is going to be like a really extremely interesting and important exploration of like a population that has been overlooked. So I also found this at an independent bookstore and I'm so happy that I did because it doesn't sound like it's going to be an easy read by any means, but it does sound like it is going to be incredibly interesting and eye-opening. And then finally, switching gears again, Tell Me If You Get Whiplash from My Tonal Shifts. That is going to be Blade of Secrets by Trisha Levenseller. And this one is a YA fantasy book about a blacksmith that makes magical weapons, I believe, and basically comes across a person that wants a magical weapon made for nefarious purposes. The weapon that this character is being asked to like craft is a blade that can take secrets from people if it's used on them. And this would be a very dangerous weapon, and the main character learns like what the intention is that it's going to be used for and does not like it one bit. And so they go on a quest to keep it safe. And apparently this is just a very fun book. It is YA, and so I'm hoping that it's going to be a really fun time. It is actually shorter than I thought that it was, so that's always a plus too because it's easier to fit in. So that is it for my little book haul. I bought entirely too much, but I did have a really good day before the pouring rain hit. I hope that you enjoyed. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. That is going to be it for this one. Like if you liked the video, subscribe if you want to see more content from me, and I hope that you have a fantastic rest of your day. Bye!